Hi Octoparse user, I'm François Dufaur. I'm a long-time user of Octoparse. In this series, I will share my experience and dive into multiple case tutorials with you, so you can use Octoparse to scrape data step by step. In this video, we are going to discover how to scrape leads and the yellow pages with Octoparse. And the yellow pages, as you all might know, is a huge database of businesses. It's a perfect source of information if you want to target small businesses in the United States. Let's get started. The first thing we need to do is to start the task with the URL of a search result page. In other words, we need to define two things: what kind of leads you are looking for and in what place they are located. So let's suppose that in this scenario, we are looking for anesthesiologist in New York City. So I simply type anesthesiologists and I tap enter. And here is the result page. So I copy the URL and I paste it in Octoparse. And once we are in the home page, I paste it and I click on start. The second step is all about creating a pagination. Well, as its name suggests, we need Octoparse to scrape multiple pages. And to do that, it's very simple. You've got here the overview of the website you want to scrape. So you need to scroll down a little bit. And here you have access to the pages. So we click on the button next. And once we've got this little box here, we click and loop click next page. Okay, so far we've got our pagination. The third step is to create a loop item. Basically, we need Octoparse to select the leads we've got in order to scrape data. So look, this is a first lead, this is a second lead, this is a third lead, and so on. And in order to select them all, we click and the first block of item. And the funny thing is that Octoparse recognize all the sub elements. Look, we've got the title, the category, the phone numbers, and the address. So we click and select sub elements and select all and extract data. And as you can see, all leads have been selected as we've got 30 lines, which represents the 30 results we've got on a page. Okay, so the aim of the step 4 is to make your result a lot easier to read. Because look, we have extracted all the sub-elements. That's correct. The point is, some pieces of information we have collected are useful, but some of them are not useful. Basically, we need Octoparse to delete the fields we don't need and to keep the fields we need and to rename them in order to make things clearer. And to do that, we click on the action settings of extract data, and now we can delete fields and rename fields. Okay, so we've got twice the name of the person, so that's not that useful. I'm going to delete the first one and to rename this field. So I tap title. We've got the category here, so I type category. I've got the link to the category. I don't think that's useful. I'm going to delete it. We've got the subcategory, so I type subcategory. And same thing, we've got the link leading to the subcategory. I'm going to delete it. Okay, so here is the final result. I just keep the title, the category, the subcategory, the sub-subcategory, the phone numbers, the address, the city, the website, because in some cases we've got a website, and the reviews. And in order to save the result, I click on OK. Step 5. Click into each page to scrape more information. Listen, this is not a must step, alright? If you already have got all the information you want, you can stop at step 4. You simply click on save, you run your task, and that's fine. But if you have some data that could only be found from the detail page, then you should follow the step 5. So in order to click into each page, we click on the blob button just here, and we click on link to scrape the linking page. Then we select click a link on the web page. I select the title of the first item and I click on confirm. And as a result, we have now access to the detail page of each URL. Step 6, scrape your data. Now you can select all the information you need, but let's suppose that on our scenario, we want to have access to the accepted insurance, for example. So I click on the accepted insurance and I click extract the text of the selected element. Same thing, I also want to get the specialties. So I click on specialties and I click on extract the text. I can also get the opening hours. In order to get it, I need to scroll down a little bit to select the regular hours and to click on extract the text. And one last thing, I also want to get the URL of each page. So I click on the action settings, I click on the plus icon, page level data and page URL. And as you can see, now we have access to the URL. And to save a task, I click on OK. The 7th step is to set up a wait time for each extract data step. The wait time is paramount because we need to let Octoparse, well, the time to load the page entirely and to scrape the data. This is why we need to click on the action settings of extract data 1 to scroll down, to click on wait before action, and now we can set up a waiting time of, let's say, 5 seconds, and we click on OK. Same thing for the first extract data item. I click on action settings, scroll down, wait before action, and a waiting time of 5 seconds, and I click on OK. Step 8, run the task. This is almost over. Now all we need to do is to save our task, to run our task, and to click and run on your device. And once it is over, you click on export data, and in our case, we will download our data in an Excel format. So I click on OK. And here is the result. Hope my video got your confusion cleared away. Please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more videos regarding Octoparse and web scraping. We will always keep you updated.